The first presenter is Seyed, Omid, Sajedi. Please come up. Who is in the Department of Civil, Structural, and Environmental Engineering. And the 3MT presentation title is Artificially Intelligent Systems for Rapid Post-Earthquake Inspections. Ready, set, pitch.
Earthquakes are terrible things. In my home country, Iran, in a city with 90,000 residents, more than two-thirds of the population lost their lives after a massive earthquake. Unfortunately, human casualties are just the tip of the iceberg. After earthquakes, most buildings and bridges cannot be used before they are properly inspected. Therefore, the economic and social consequences could be very severe and potentially escalate beyond the seismic zone. A recent report showed that an earthquake in California, which supplies 30% of the food in the whole United States, could cost over $200 billion. Just imagine the consequence of shutting down this interchange for a few days. It's going to be bad. We need to quickly know if our civil infrastructures are safe so people can get back to their normal lives as soon as possible. Having said that, information on structural safety is crucial not to just rescue people, but also to minimize these economic losses. Unfortunately, human inspections are not a good option. They require a lot of time and money. And even if these resources are available, are you willing to go inside a building or under a bridge like this that may collapse any minute? I know I'm not, and that's the reason my research at UB is focused on developing systems that can predict damage in real time. Like a human heart monitor, structural vibrations tell us a lot about the condition of our buildings. With the help of structural dynamics and artificial intelligence, we are trying to translate these vibrations into damage in just a few seconds. My research is dedicated to making damage detectors that can work reliably even in very noisy environments. Therefore, our artificial neural networks are trained and tested for thousands of earthquake simulations, so they can predict various types of damage. As a result, by placing a few accelerometers here and there on a bridge or a building, you can quickly predict not only the locations of damage, but also their severities. Sadly, history and science have taught us that earthquakes are inevitable, but disasters don't have to be. With the help of my research, we are trying to train robot doctors for our cities. Then they are giving us valuable information so we can take proper actions immediately after the earthquakes. The efforts of me and my colleagues will take us several steps closer to a faster recovery and building more resilient communities against these natural disasters. Thank you so much, everyone, and stay safe.
Thank you, Seyed.